Myths. 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 That is not a myth. Now that is a myth. There are myths to explain everything. Want to know how the world came to be? There's a myth to that. How about a myth to explain why people are so insecure for the way they look? Oh wait, there's a myth for that too. There are many, and I mean many, myths. But the myths we now know today have one major flaw. They are not modern. So, for my project, I have decided to create a modern creation myth. The myth will explain the creation of distrust.
Distrust, to have no trust or confidence in someone or something.
I know that something like this has happened to you, and I know that you distrust at least someone or something. Now, I hope you guys enjoyed the presentation, as I made it with haste, due to Optimum Support being idiotic. We begin with the story taking place in the 21st century. The future is now. Technology is at an all-time high. Thousands of innovative inventions to help the future of the world. There are 3D printers, electric cars, and even meat that was made out of plants. Yummy. So it begins, with Voidachi being placed into the story. For a bit of background information of Voidachi, he is an engineer working at a big company in which he tries his best to create modern inventions that will benefit mankind and the planet in which he lives on Earth. He is somewhat of a loner, and he never really works with other people, fearing that they will mess something up for him. Just so you know, he is the main character, so we will focus on him the most. Voidachi is in his lab, working on an invention. This invention seems to be different, as it is not like any other invention created by him or anyone else in the world. The invention he was working on was deemed to give the person using the invention immortality. One day, Voidachi was working in his office area when he spotted a figure skulking inside of his office. He seemed interested in the invention of immortality, whom Voidachi was still working on. Voidachi, mad at the fact that he's trespassing on his room, barges into the door in an attempt to ascertain the cause of his trespassing.
"Why are you in my room? You are not allowed here,"
Voidachi said at the figure. The figure turns around, revealing his appearance. Voidachi has not remembered anyone in the building who resembles the person he sees now.
"State your name,"
Voidachi told the figure. "Hello," the person finally says. "My name is Ion Lecker, and I am new to this company. I'm an engineer, just like you, wanting to innovate the world into greatness. I have been watching the development of your creations, and my esteem for you has ever grown so highly." Voidachi starts to get startled. He wonders why the onlooker seems so nonchalant in telling him all of this, especially when he was caught red-handed trespassing. His appearance also seems uncanny at best. The onlooker seems to be wearing shady clothing, as if he is stealing something. But there are no signs of anything being stolen in his office.
"Well then, may I ask why you have decided to break into my office only to muse in it?"
The onlooker takes a second to reply. "Well, because, this may seem stupid, but I actually want to work with you. As I told you before, my esteem for you grows higher and higher each time I see your inventions. I would like to work with you, as if I'm your apprentice, to accomplish the impossible." Voidachi, looking at the timer, notices that the beginning of his story is taking too long. He decides to allow the onlooker to work with him instantly, to save time and to save the sanity of the narrator and editor of this video, which is me, by the way.
"Nevertheless, I will let you work with me."
"Sweet," the onlooker says. Voidachi clears a space in his office for him, and they both start working on projects together. It has been a year since Voidachi and the onlooker met each other. They have impressed the company with their inventions, as their ideas result in the finest works of the year. Needless to say, Voidachi's trust and esteem for the onlooker grows highly as ever. Remember that immortality machine Voidachi created? Well, now he's going back to it, but with the onlooker on his side. Voidachi trusts him enough to work on the machine with him, knowing full well that the machine will take a long time to build. They take forever to build the machine. They have tested it many times to no avail. Days go into weeks, and weeks goes into years, and they have finally finished it.
Looks like it does work. The company will be proud of us in making it.
Yeah, us. Now, fast forward to company presentations. Voidachi and the onlooker have reserved a time to let the CEO of their company watch them present this magnificent machine. The onlooker walks to talk. Greetings. I am pleased to announce that we have invented a machine in which immortality is possible to achieve. Never will we mourn the loss of a loved one, and never will we be afraid of dying. This machine will aid us in evolving technology for mankind greatly. Allow me to demonstrate. Over here is a human test subject. Watch him enter the pod. As I flip the switch, the machine starts, then stops, and the human looks unaffected by it. Now, as you are going to watch, I am going to shoot him with this gun I have. See? Not effective. As if he's invulnerable to it.
Wonderful invention. I am blown away by this concept of a machine.
Why, thank you, sir.
And who made this wonderful invention?
I did, sir, and Voidachi somewhat helped me in making it. Of course, I spent the most time thinking of perfecting this invention.
Well, you, sir, are the future of this company. I am pleased to say that I am promoting you to head engineer. Gone are the days you work under someone, but now comes the days where you can freely present your ideas to your own team, building it to benefit mankind. Voidachi, on the other hand, I guess I'll just give you a raise for somewhat helping, I guess.
Voidachi was furious. He has never experienced such a rage before that after they presented, he immediately went to the onlooker to confront him.
What the hell, man? I was the one who came up with the machine and started building it way before we even met, and I trusted you enough to help me work on it.
It's no big deal, really. There are other projects you can take credit on, seriously. This made Voidachi crack. At her age, he installed a virus, which turns the next person who uses the machine into a monkey. The next day, the CEO requests the onlooker to let him use the machine, in which he accepts. As the CEO goes in and flips the switches, the onlooker watches him as he turns into a monkey. And when they open the pod, the monkey starts to go crazy, running around in the building. Soon after, everyone got word of what the onlooker did to the CEO, and never trusted him again with another project, always questioning his antics when he is present. And that, my friends, is the modern nature myth of the creation of distrust. A moral from this tragic story is to never take credit for something that isn't yours. I hope you enjoyed it. I don't really like sad endings, so I'll end this video with an explanation. I just want you guys to know why the middle to end of this video was so choppy and looked unfinished. If you want the answer to that, it's just time. I literally spent only Friday and Saturday making this video, as I couldn't get a head start because my router died on me and my internet provider, Optimum, decided to fix it on Thursday, so I couldn't even start it until they fixed it. Talk about bad timing.